Hi, I'm Anastasia. Welcome to this yoga flow practice that is prenatal appropriate. Please always check with your physician prior to starting this or any exercise program. But just because this is prenatal yoga does not mean those who are not pregnant can't participate. You certainly can. I'm not going to be doing deep twists, lying on the belly, or lying on my back. If these are movements that are safe for you, you're welcome to incorporate them as we practice. Today we're focusing on the hips. Lots of stretching of the outer hips and inner thigh. For someone like myself, I'm 29 weeks pregnant right now. This is really beneficial. A lot of tightness in here and interesting feelings, but for all of us, we have the potential to carry stress through the hips. So this is a great way to help us relieve stress by releasing the hips, provide some mobility and flexibility in that area. Let's go ahead and find a comfortable seated position. Does not have to be crossed legs, but it can be. Sit up nice and tall, stack one vertebra on top of the other, crown of your head reaching up to the ceiling. Give your shoulders a big roll up to your ears and down and back, creating lots of space between earlobes and shoulders. Hands resting comfortably in your lap. Start to move your breath in and out your nose only. You're welcome to close your eyes or soften your gaze as you do so. Deep inhales through the nose, filling up the chest cavity and abdomen completely with air. And full exhales also out the nose, nice and slow. With your next few inhales, take a little inventory of your body, noting how all the different parts of it are feeling today. If any part of it is in need of some extra care or attention, just make a mental note of it so that you can do so throughout our practice. With your next few exhales, let go of your day, anything you've already done, whatever you have left to do, anything troubling your mind or your spirit, just drifting away. With your body and mind connected in your space, please silently set an intention for your practice. It could be something physical, like becoming more flexible, or something mental like finding peace. Set yours silently now. Maintain this nasal breath throughout our practice, and you're welcome to have your eyes closed at any time. Just be aware that this affects your balance. Keeping the rest of the spine nice and long in your comfortable seated position, shoulders down and back, drop your chin toward your chest. Roll your right ear toward your right shoulder and continue in this slow circle. Thinking about lengthening those vertebrae rather than crunching them down. Once the chin reaches your chest again, reverse direction. pausing with your chin at your chest. And then we'll inhale open, lifting the chest and face, exhaling to round. Follow your breath as you inhale and exhale, knowing that we never have to use the same range of motion. We never have to move in unison. Next, exhale, find neutral spine. I'm going to shake those legs out for a moment, especially if you have had them folded. And we're going to come into a stacked logs position. You're going to place your left leg on bottom, and the right leg is going to go on top. So we want some space between the groin and the calves, and it's okay if one leg is in front, or if that knee is way up in the air. Let's take a big inhale, reach up. Exhale, side bend. Opening that heart up toward the ceiling, keeping your sitting bones connected to your mat. Next inhale, reach up. And exhale, take it up and over. Reach up. Exhale, twist to your right. So if you are pregnant, we don't want to do a closed twist where we're cutting off circulation there, so we can keep the hand on the same knee. If it's safe for you to reach across, go ahead. Next, inhale, lift. Exhale, twist. Same or opposite leg. And inhale, lift. Exhale, we fold it over. Again, keeping the sitting bones grounded. With every exhale, maybe we walk those fingertips further away. Relax your head and neck. Inhale and exhale, slide up. Take another big inhale. Exhale, take it over. Relax your head and neck, sitting bones grounded as we walk the fingertips out and away. And this time you can take the hands over to the right side of your mat. Notice how the posture changes, the changes you feel in the muscles that are lengthening. And let's come through center to go to the left. Walk it to center, inhale, and exhale, slide up. Let's shake those legs out again before we come to the other side. This time your right leg on bottom. Your left leg comes on top or in front, and we want that space between the groin and the calves. Stacked logs, this is sometimes called double pigeon. We'll take an inhale, lift, and exhale. We'll come to the left first this time. You can gaze wherever you want. And next inhale, lift, and exhale, side bend. And inhale, lift. Exhale, twist to your left first. Coming to the same or opposite knee. Shoulders down from those earlobes. Every inhale, sitting taller. Every exhale, twisting more. And inhale, lift. Exhale, twist. Lift, exhale, fold. Relax your head and neck. Sitting bones grounded as we walk the fingers out and away. Exhale, slide up. And again, we take a big inhale to reach. Exhale to fold. Relax your head and neck. Fingers walk out and away. And this time we'll walk over to the left side of our mat first. Over to the right side of your mat through center. Walk it back to center. Inhale and exhale, slide up. So let's take a wide leg fold here just to open up those inner thighs. In that area of the hip, take it as wide as you want. We're flexing those toes up toward the ceiling, even though you can't see mine right now. And this could be much narrower. That's completely up to your body. Inhale, reach, and exhale, fold. This should feel really nice after being folded up. Take it where you need to. Gaze at the floor. And recognize that if you are pregnant, our bodies produce the hormone relaxin. Our muscles and tendons and ligaments become looser to help prepare for childbirth. So we want to be cautious not to overstretch. So maybe don't take it to the edge. Bring it back a little bit from that place. Inhale and exhale. Bring it up. Let's go ahead and come on to our hands and knees. Wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, tops of the feet relaxed on the mat. Inhaling and exhaling through cat-cow. Inhale, face and hips lift, belly drops. Exhale to round, drawing the navel up and in. Follow your breath. Articulate the spine. After your next exhale, find neutral spine, neither arched nor rounded, gazing just beyond your fingertips with your belly lifted. Spread your fingers wide, index fingers forward, tuck your toes, lift back and up, downward facing dog. Press your chest back toward your thighs, look through your legs. Feel free to pedal or wiggle, just doing what feels good. Thank you.
drop to your knees, taking them as wide as you want. Big toes together behind you, hips back to your heels. Forehead can come to your mat as the arms reach. They can come behind your head in prayer or around the legs. You can come to your child's pose anytime you need it. Let's come to hands and knees again. Inhaling and exhaling through cat-cow. One more cycle of breath. Spine. Spread your fingers, tuck your toes, downward facing dog. Again, you can pedal or wiggle, raise up and down, do what feels good. And let's walk the feet up to the hands. They're somewhat separated as you melt into forward fold. Top of the head draws down. Shake it yes and no. Make sure it's dangling heavy, like a bowling ball from a string. Grasp your elbows if you'd like and rock or sway. Let go the elbows and roll up slowly. You can support on those thighs if you want. Shoulders move down and back. Abdomen and tailbone pulled in and mountain pose, Tadasana. It's also a very convenient resting posture. Should you need it. So we move through a few sun salutations. I am not going to go all the way to my belly. Again, if this is safe for you to go all the way to your belly, feel free to. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Relax your head and neck. Inhale, half lift, look forward, flatten your back, touching shins, thighs, or floor. Exhale, hands come down, walk, step, or jump to your plank. You can move from your toes or your knees to support the spine. Inhale, exhale, chaturanga, elbows go straight back as you float down. Feel free to come all the way to the belly if you wish. You can come into cobra or upward facing dog. Shoulders and earlobes far apart. Come all the way down if you wish to release back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk, step, or jump forward. Release and fold. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, palms to your heart. And again, we inhale, lift, exhale, fold, inhale, half lift, look forward, flatten your back, exhale, walk, step, or jump to your plank, toes or knees, inhale, exhale, chaturanga, foot down, inhale, into your back bend of choice, and exhale. Downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk, step, or jump forward. Release and fold. Inhale, lift up. palms to your heart. Once more, inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half lift. Look forward, flatten your back. Exhale, walk, step, or jump to your plank. Inhale, exhale, chaturanga, float down. Inhale, into your back bend. And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, walk, step, or jump forward. Release and fold. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, palms to your heart. Pausing for a moment. Thumbs at your sternum. Feel that heart beating a little faster. Ensure that your breath is moving in and out your nose. Remind yourself of your intention. We continue to move. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale to your plank. Coming through our vinyasa, inhale, exhale, chaturanga, your back bend, and find your downward facing dog. Lift your right leg up, three-legged dog. Feel that nice stretch in the back of the left leg. Inhale, exhale, step your right foot forward. Big step to get it up between your hands, and we stand up with all 10 toes looking forward. Lift your back knee, crescent high lunge. We lift up, inhale. Exhale, right arm floats down and left arm comes up and over to further stretch that hip. Gaze wherever you want. Lift. Exhale, rotate outward. Palms come to your heart. All 10 toes are looking out as we send into our side lunge, Skandasana. So we're going to lift those toes up. And we can stay here. Or if it works for our knees to come lower, we can lift that heel off of the floor. Try to lift your chest. And again, if coming down this low does not work, especially for your knee, please stay up high. So we can stay low as we rotate, or if you're up higher, you'll rotate from there. Hands gonna come inside the foot. We're gonna rotate those back toes. You can place your other hand on your knee or reach up as we rotate. Rotated side angle. Try to drop that knee out to the side. So this is what it looks like from the front. We can support on the knee, so we're not compressing here. We can open up and we can drop that knee out to the side to create even more space. Let's further stretch that hip. Hand comes down, leg goes back. Inhale and exhale, swing it forward to pigeon. Shin coming to where it's trying to be parallel with the front of the mat. If it's not, that's okay. Let me show you from the front here too. You are going to keep your hip away from the floor. We're not going to dump out. And if we need to draw that heel closer, can. We just relax into it as much as we're able to. If you want to come down, you can. So I don't have space to come down all the way flat, but maybe you do. Those hands if we're low. Tuck those back toes to energize the knee. We step back to downward facing dog. Just a reset here. Reach your left leg up, three-legged dog. Big inhale, big exhale. Step that foot forward. All 10 toes look forward as we stand up. Crescent high lunge, lift that back knee. We can fold the left arm down. Right arm reaches up and over. Breathe. Palms come to the heart as we rotate. We can keep that toe lifted as we sit, coming as low as you want. If you get really low, we want to lift that heel. Try to lift your chest. If you're up high, you'll rotate and get low. If we're down low, we can scoot it over. Hand comes inside as we rotate those back toes. We can put that hand on the knee, or we can open up. We can drop that knee out to the side. Gaze where you want. Comes down, lift that knee if it's out. We take that leg back. Big inhale, we'll get that nice stretch here. And exhale, we bring that shin forward to come as parallel with the front of the mat as we're able to get it. Again, we want to keep the hip off of the floor. We don't want to dump out into it, or else we're not going to get much of an outer hip stretch here. And you can come down if that works. Send your breath into the tight places. Low, tuck the back toe to lift the knee, and we'll send it back to our downward facing dog. Just lengthen it here for a moment, and then you can rest into child's pose. Taking those arms wherever you want. Refocusing upon your intention. Slowing and controlling your nasal breath. come up to hands and knees. As we move through those postures one more time, hopefully you'll be feeling some increased flexibility and mobility. Tuck your toes, lift back and up, downward facing dog. Right leg lifts, three-legged dog, big stretch, inhale. Exhale, right foot forward, nice and long. All 10 toes look forward as we stand up to crescent high lunge. Right arm drops, left arm reaches up and over. Rotate open as your palms come to your heart. We lift those front toes. You can stay up high or we can sink it down low, raising that heel. We keep that chest lifted. We're kind of sitting on that heel. If we're low, only if it works for the knee. If you're low, you can kind of crawl through center. If you're up high, you'll just rotate. Left hand comes down, back toes rotate. Rotated side angle. Your hand can come to the knee to open up or lift and drop that knee open if it feels good and gaze where you want. Float the hand down, raise the knee, take that leg back, inhale, and exhale. Shin comes forward to pigeon pose, keeping that hip off the floor, lengthening, coming low if you want. Sure, we're not compressing the belly. If you are pregnant, let's walk it up. If we're low, tuck the back toes, energize the back knee, and step back. Downward facing dog. Just livening up that front leg again. Lift your left leg, three-legged dog. Nice big stretch in that right leg. Inhale, exhale, step forward. All 10 toes look forward as we stand up and reach. Back knee is lifted. Left arm comes down, right arm comes up and over. Lift up. Palms come to your heart as you rotate open. What was our front toes lifts? We can stay up a little higher or we can sit it down lower and lift that heel. Skandasana. Side lunge. Lift your chest. Down low, you can move through low center. Up high, you're just going to rotate and then come low. Right hand comes inside, back toes rotate, hand to the knee, or reaching, knee can come out to the side if you want. In this version of rotated side angle. Hand floats down as we lift the knee, take that leg back. Inhale and exhale, coming into pigeon. Elongate that back leg. Make sure we're lifting off the hip, coming low if that works. Again, making sure not to compress the belly if that's not safe. Walk it up. Back toes tuck, lift the knees, step back. Downward facing dog. Wiggle it out a little bit. And then drop into one more child's pose. Returning to the breath and the intention always. Let's walk it up. We're going to find a seated position again. So let's first find that wide V. Toes are flexed. Another nice stretch for our inner thighs. Inhale, reach, and exhale. Take it where you need to. Should feel good after we've done some deep knee bends to be here. I'm going to bring those legs in, and we're going to find cradle pose. Pick your right knee up. It's going to go into the crook of your right elbow, and we're going to grab that foot with the other hand. Shoulders stay down. We stay sitting up tall. It might work for you to cradle with both arms. It might not. We never want to sacrifice our posture here. Feel free to rock. Take that leg up and down, whatever feels good. And now we're going to place that leg down outside of the left leg, sitting tall. Inhale, reach, and exhale, open twist. So we don't have to be drawn in closely here, certainly not. Open twist, we're keeping that space for the belly. Inhale and exhale, release. Extend that right leg out long. And we're going to pick up that left knee, bringing it into the crook of the left elbow. It can come to the hand or the crook of that right elbow. Make sure you're giving your belly plenty of space. You need rock, foot up and down, whatever feels good. then let's take that foot outside the leg, taking it as far away as needed for space for the belly. Inhale, reach, and exhale, twist. Spiraling those vertebrae up to the ceiling. And release to center. We'll take those legs wide one more time. Inhale, reach. And exhale, we fold, taking it where you need to. Hopefully you're noticing now that maybe you're able to go wider or lower than you were in that first instance of this wide leg seated forward fold. And let's walk it up. We're going to bring those legs in. Soles of feet together, heels far from the groin. Inhale and exhale, round it over. Height pose, forehead toward the insteps of the feet. Inhale and exhale. Bring it up. We're getting ready to move into our shavasana, traditionally done flat on the back. But if flat on the back does not work for you, which it is not a good option for me right now either, you're welcome to lay on your side, take a comfortable seat, your sukhasana again, whatever position you need to safely relax. I will guide us into and out of shavasana and close our practice together. So I won't leave you hanging in case you're catching a little nap. Let's come all the way down. Maybe you're on your back, maybe you're on your side, maybe you're seated. Wherever you are, let those strong, supple hips just melt into your mat. They're mobile, they're flexible, but they are strong. All of our other muscles melt into our mat. Toes and fingers relax. Your face relaxes, your brow relaxes. Your eyes close. So you let go of your breath. And let your mind move away to somewhere very, very peaceful.
wiggle your fingers and toes, slowly waking them up. Rock your head from side to side. And when you're ready, roll onto either side into a fetal position, unless you're already there. When you're ready, use your two strong arms to push you into a comfortable seated position. Does not have to be crossed legs, but it can be. Sit up nice and tall. Stack one vertebra on top of the other. We're gonna roll those shoulders down and back. Again, drop your chin toward your chest. We'll take these nice slow neck circles one more time. Nice and slow and easy. Just noticing here too how different this might feel after all of the stretching and our relaxation. Once your chin reaches your chest, reverse again. Pause with your chin at your chest and lift your face, sitting tall. Close your eyes once more. Reflect upon your intention. Thank yourself for working toward it. Recognize that you did not just do something good for your hips, your inner, your outer thighs, but you did something wonderful for your body, your mind, and your spirit. Take a big inhale, lift up. Exhale through the mouth. Thank you so much for letting me teach you today. Namaste. Thank you for joining me. Again, my name is Anastasia. This channel through Anastasia. I would love for you to like and subscribe. You'll see weekly, the day varies, a new yoga practice. These are all prenatal focused for now. I selfishly am making them that way, but hopefully you're able to tailor this practice to challenge your needs. And again, always do so safely. Always check with a healthcare provider before you begin this or any exercise program. Thank you so much. Nefertiti, my cat, thanks you too. Have a beautiful day.